All right, folks, we'll get started here in just a few seconds.
Your show will go live in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Log Talk Radio.
Want to know how that you can make up to 20,000 and even more this summer? Well, stay tuned.
It's that time again, folks, broadcasting live with his tin cans and a brand new string from a top hole Smokey. It's Ben, the king of wiener slingers, with a fancy co-host, with important guests, and the best answers a third grade education can buy. All for you. Sponsored by BensCarts.com, whiskey by the jug and donuts. You are so in for a treat today. But if I told you now, I'd have to kill you. So stay tuned. Ben's as nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. Stand by. He's downing his last glass of liquid courage, and he'll be live in 30 seconds.
Have you ever wondered why the guy selling hot dogs always seems so happy?
Hello, Mrs. Smith. Hello, Mr. Johnson. Can I interest either of you in a hot dog? Do you want to find out why? LearnHotDogs.com. Get free video training, earn points, and get free stuff. Read Ben's hot dog blog and more. The premier source for hot dog vending information. Go to LearnHotDogs.com.
Well, howdy, howdy, folks, and welcome to another episode of Street Food Vendor TV and Hot Dog Vendor Radio. I'm glad that you are with me. I am excited. We're going to talk about how to make $20,000 this summer. You don't have summer is upon us. I don't think we're getting a spring this year. And I have left my cowboy hat upstairs, so you're going to get to stare at my beautiful bald head. I did shave it this morning, though, so I'm looking good. Let's see. I was late getting in here, and so I thought I wasn't even going to have this ready in time. And so I was running like a, I was nervous, like a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs, kind of nervous, trying to get everything situated. I wanted to answer some questions, and you're welcome to call in. We have a live call-in number, 424-258-9364. You're welcome to call that number. You press option 1, and it tells me, hey, I want to talk. Otherwise, you can just listen. We are going to cover some tips on how to make $20,000 this summer or more. And we're going to use realistic numbers gathered from literally over 1,500 vendors that have shared numbers with me over the last few years. And kind of weed out the good luck success, you know, immediate wham bam, you know, I went out in 2 days, made $9,000 kind of stuff. We're going to go to a realistic number and show you how everything can be done and talk about the different ways to make that happen. If you've been vending a while, we're even going to talk about how to change some things up to get those to working too. I will be taking calls throughout. So if you'd like to make a call, it's 424-258-9364, press option 1. And that lets me know that you're on the line. Barring that, I haven't seen Mr. Jason Brown with Love Hot Dog Company as of yet. I sent him the link about 4 minutes ago. I think it was 8:56, and he was probably wondering where the link is, the special link to get into the show live. So that's where we are. I have I've had a busy week, and I am excited to be here. I have some questions that were emailed in. I'm going to try to run through some of those. If I don't get them on the show, I will just email you back. I save some out occasionally. Some I answer, and then I still save them out so that I can present them on the show. But that's where we are. Let's see. There are vendors that are going to make $20,000 and more this summer, okay? And lots of vendors that will do this. And I'm not talking vendors with 9 hot dog carts or somebody like Jason Brown. It's a given, okay? He'll probably do that this month. I'm talking about the vendors with a hot dog cart, a hot dog cart. And it sounds like a lot of money, and mostly because it is. But when you average it out, and let's say you use only those realistic numbers that I was telling you about earlier, we can see just how possible this becomes. And so what I'm going to take you through is a little bit of math, and you can write down as you want. If you're like me, you have a yellow pad handy. If not, then grab any color paper. It won't be as good as a yellow one, but it'll work. So here's what we have. 3 months, let's call it, for summer. Some of us get longer summers. Some of us get about 3 months. The average, probably 3 months. It's definitely the time when the kids are out of school. So 3 months of summer. Average month has 4.3 weeks in it, okay? Because if you take 4 weeks, 7 days a week, time, that's 28 days. Most months are 30 to 31 days. So they do an average of 4.3 weeks in a month. So if you, just a side note here, if you ever get someone that says, oh, you can pay your rent weekly, you will end up paying 13 months out of the year, because there's 52 weeks in a year, and that is exactly 13 months worth of weeks. So keep that in mind when somebody tries to give you a weekly payment instead of a monthly payment. But using my figure of 4.3 weeks in a month, and I'm not going to work all week, and most don't. There are some that do. Let's say 4 days a week, and that will account for our rain days, our emergency fishing trip days, and kids sick and I got to stay home, wife sick or husband sick or whatever it is. Those are the days. I got a dentist appointment or whatever it is. So we're gonna figure 4 days a week of work times 4.3, which is roughly 17 days a month. Doesn't sound like much, does it? You're working 17 days a month. That means roughly you're getting off 13 days a month. Now, or 14, depending on the month. So those are those days for those types of events that you can't control or that you want free time. Free time with the family, free time with friends, free time with your girlfriends, whatever it is. Now, take those 3 months and multiply it times 17, okay? And 3 times 17 is 51. So what you have is 3 months of work, 17 days of work a month is 51 days. So out of a 3 month period, roughly 90 days, you're going to work 51 of those days, a little over half. Now let's take the 20,000 and divide it by the 51. This will tell us we want to make 20,000, but we are only working 51 days. We're not dividing it by 90 days. We're dividing it by the days we're working. And so the working days is 51. And that gives us a total around, there's some pennies here, but 392 daily. Now, some of you probably are going to call me or email me and go, but I don't make 392 a day. And we're going to talk about that in a little bit, so hang on, okay? Because there's some vendors that are making 150 bucks a day and 250 bucks a day. And then there's some vendors making 500 and 600 a day and some making more than that. So I wanted to use some realistic numbers, though, because my goal was, when I got going, is I wanted 100 meals a day off my cart, roughly, an average. So I wasn't upset if I got 80 or 60, because there was days when I got 140. So I wanted to figure out how to do this. So we've divided how many days we're going to work in the 3 months. We know that we want 20 grand, a little over 6 grand a month, and we know that we're going to have to work 51 days out of that 3 month period, which is $392 a day average. Some days more, some days less, but the average needs to be $392 to meet this goal. So how can you make $392 in a day? And I go by meal deals. And if any of you have read my course book, Hot Dogs Save My Life, or have been over on the blog or watched any of my training videos, I talk about a $5 meal deal. Well, as things have changed, and I don't know if you've recognized, but over the last few years, our groceries have almost doubled. Now, wholesale food costs haven't doubled really, but they've gone up. So now what used to be my $5 meal deal, where you got two dogs, a bag of chips, and a drink for $5, I encourage new vendors to use $6. It's more reasonable. It's more logical. Unless you're really, really buying in bulk enough that it doesn't matter, then I'd go to $6. I've got some vendors that are selling regular hot dogs. Regular hot dogs, like Baker's and Chef, like I do, that are getting $3.50 a dog or $3 a dog and without any problems. So $6 meal with a drink, two dogs, and chips is cheap. Now, divide six, okay? That's the $6 your sale amount into $392, and you get about 65 meals a day to meet that number. And you're probably going, well, that's not bad, 65 customers a day. And it isn't that bad, but it's not accurate. And here's why it's not accurate. I don't like to work on gross. I don't want to earn $20,000 gross. I want to earn $20,000 net. The difference between net and gross is total income, but we haven't taken out expenses. And that food and that labor and that gas and the tires and the ice and the tinfoil and napkins all cost money. So we have a cost. Now I'm going to use a blanket average. I've seen some vendors go under this. I've seen some vendors go over this. And this is all determined on how you price things. But my average cost was about 33%. But that 33% included everything, not just the cost of goods sold, not just that the money that it cost me to buy the hot dog, mustard, relish, chili, and bun. It was also my other things, the things that were consumable around the cart, paper towels, napkins, tinfoil, stuff that you don't count as food items, but they're consumables. They're continually going in and out, and there's no way to not count those. My propane, my ice, my time, as far as time with money, like I know that it's going to cost me this much money to drive to a location if it's $7 and $7 back, and then I'm going to have to run through the car wash and spray my cart down or whatever I'm doing, however I'm doing it. Those are all costs, and I wanted all those costs in there when I was doing this full time, and my cost averaged about 32 to 33%. And it was because my low price on my value meal. Go up on the value meal, now my cost goes down because my cost stay the same, but my profit went up, which means the percentage of cost to pull out of the gross is less. So I hope you're following me so far. So we need to take that out, that 33%. So our cost daily for 51 days is about $131, which means out of the $392 that I need to make a day, cost is $131. Well, like I said, I want to make $20,000. I don't want to make $20,000 minus 33%. I want to make $20,000 profit. So 51 days is $131 for each day, which equates to about 22 more meals I need to serve. Okay? So I need to serve 8 instead of 65. I need to be serving, 87 meals a day in order to ensure, on average, that I get my $20,000 in 3 months. 51 days of work, $20,000 profit. And I'm talking total profit, net, 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 net. Now, this may seem like a lot, and it may be more than some of you average now, but I just used numbers based on only working 17 days a month. Folks like Corey, Jason, Ron, and I could, the list goes on and on and on and on. I think there's two different Bobs, and many others work much more. Working 20 days a month means your average daily sales can be much less because it added 9 days over that 3 month period. You added 3 months to 3 days to each month. So instead of working 17 days a month, you're going to work 20 days a month. And now you don't need to have such a high average in order to get the $20,000. But you're trading out working more, which isn't the end of the world. So I get emails daily, and I talk to many vendors each day, and I can assure you that 88 meals is a day is doable. But if you're not doing that, then we need to make some changes, okay? So I've already shown you how we need to make 87 sales a day at $6 meals on average. All this is averaged. So that we end up with basically not $3.92 a day. We need to be around $500 a day for those 51 days. Because remember, we were at $3.92, then we had the $131 in cost. Well, we want that cost back because we want that to be profit. So we need to really be in the $500 range daily. Is it doable? Absolutely. And many vendors are doing it. Now, many vendors aren't as well. So don't feel bad and don't beat yourself up, because that's what we're going to go into next. We're going to talk about how to change how much you're making daily. Okay, and we're going to talk about the many options you have. So bear with me, and I'll be right back.
Want to see some funky videos? Go to learnhotdogs.com. You can watch Ben do it on a real big dog cart. He'll also teach you how to steam, boil, and grill dogs the right way on the same cart. He'll also show you how to get your hands on some hot, steamy buns. And it's all over at learnhotdogs.com. This is Slick Willie Johnson from New York, and you'll be grooving live with the Hot Dog and some Man on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
By the way, the shirt I'm wearing tonight, I don't know if you can see it with my belly. It makes it rounder. It's the Hot Dog Mafia shirt. You don't have to be a member to get one. And there's also the sexy hot dog shirt. It just has a hot dog on it. And those are one of our past vendors that has since retired from vending, and she makes shirts on the side. She used the money to help the veterans. The shirts are made by veterans. I don't know if you can see the sleeve right there. I was pulling the wrong arm. My camera's backwards. So anyway, they're made, you know, in the U.S., and they're made, and it supports veterans. And I think that's awesome. But it also supports her and her. She has an animal shelter. And she, an animal rescue. So if you would like a shirt, what I've done to spice up the deal, I think you can get two shirts for, I don't remember what they are. Maybe somebody will tell me. But anyway, you can go to our Facebook page and go down it, and you'll see her post by others. You'll see her post. You'll see where I've shared the post, and it will show one of these sexy shirts. You can get the shirt. She leaves on vacation, I believe, Thursday. So you want to order before then. If you order two shirts, you get my $95 A to Z course absolutely free. She'll send you a link and a password and everything to that course. So I wanted to throw that out there so you knew about it. They are nice shirts, and I think I look good in it. It's thinning. So what 20 pounds the camera put on me, the shirt took off. Let's see. Now, I want to talk about what our options are if we're not making $392 or $500 a day. What do we need to do to change that? Now, I want you to know, all of this is contingent on whether you want the 20 grand. You could say, oh, I don't need 20 grand. I'd be tickled pink with 10 grand. I'd be tickled pink with 9 grand. That's $3,000 a month in profit. Well, and that's a good living. And I'm not saying anything's wrong with that. I just always wanted more, and my kids, oh my gosh, just a year ago, 2 years ago even, I had 4 kids in college at the same time. So you can imagine that I need to make more than that, and depending on what you need to make, you can alter these numbers. I'm just giving you how to do it. You can fool around with this and make it fit you. Maybe you want 30 grand in 3 months. Doable. You could want 20 grand in 1 month. Is it doable? Abso-freaking-lutely. And it's done. It's done. It's being done. So I don't want to blow smoke up your butts, but and you know, feed you sunshine basically and go, yeah, it's awesome. You can stay at home and make lots of money. No, this requires work. And as you know, if you're vending already, you already know. You can already, you know, high five with me and know that this is work. But it is some really good pay for the hours you put in. Because a hot dog vendor day, that 51 days we were talking about working earlier, isn't for 10-hour days or 12-hour days. Most vendors are working 3 or 4 hours, and then they got an hour to prep and clean up. So they're not putting in 10 and 12 hour days. Some do, and I do if it's an event or a charity thing or whatever. But I'm talking about on average. You go out there for lunch, or I was doing like the factory gig, you know, and I know some vendors doing that now too, that are there's some in Kentucky, no, West Virginia, and they're working coal mines at night, feeding miners. So there's some cool things you can do. And they're not working all night because the coal miners get a break, just like in the day, and you get a lunch break. And so they're getting that lunch break in the middle of the night. The vendor's there for an hour or two, and he's gone. And he goes 7 days a week. Some of them do it 7 days a week. I didn't. I did it 2 days a week. So if you have enough people that want hot dogs every night, and there's enough people that even these 300 aren't going to have hot dogs because they just had them for the last 3 days in a row, you got this other 400 people that want them. So those things happen. And so that works out. My factory gig, it didn't work out that way, so I worked 2 days a week. And then everybody, almost everybody, knew that on Tuesdays and Thursdays, Hillbilly Hot Dogs was going to be there, and they could get hot dogs, so they didn't bring their lunch, their midnight lunch. So you can change any of these numbers, but I'm still playing off the numbers that I gave you. They're realistic, they're doable, and everybody probably would be happy with it. There's a few that make far more, and they wouldn't be happy with this. This would be a down sell. But for most of us, I'd be tickled pink. I mean, every month you're looking at, what, $6,400 or something a month profit? That's a good living. I mean, you're just shy of $100,000 a year. So let's go to how can we change this if you're not doing it? If you're making $150 but you want to be making $5, you're making $300 and you want to be making $5, you've got some options. You can work more days, which I don't care for as much, but I'll do it. If it needs to be done, I'll do it. One of the other things you can do is change locations. Now, we've talked about this on many shows, and this comes down to good record keeping, and I'll go into that in just a second a little bit, but you can change locations. So if you know your location is doing good on these days and not so good on these days, then you find a new location for these days so that you can capitalize on the maximum amount you can make on that location. And then on Thursday and Friday, you're over at this location because it's the best. And if you don't know what's the best yet, you keep trying, but you keep good records. Otherwise, it's all guessing, and you'll never get it right. You'll never know for sure. So keep good records. And I don't care if you keep the most simplest records in the planet. I've got a long show about record keeping that is important that everybody should watch if you haven't watched it. I keep records on a yellow pad, nothing fancy. And I keep several columns, and it tells me. And then we had some vendors share their record keeping, their daily sales log. And those are free, I believe, at benscarts.com. You can click on accessory store, go to the forums, and they're free to download. And you can try some. In fact, Michael Wood gave everybody his Excel spreadsheet, which he keeps his daily log. The reason Michael Wood knows exactly which days he makes the most money at which location, I think he works 3 different locations, the reason he knows this is because he keeps good records. So your first choice was work more days. Your second is to change locations. Maybe not change locations, but add another location and give up some days at a certain location so that you can make the most for your time. Because that's what it comes down to. You've only got a certain amount of time that you're going to give to this. So why not make the best of it? If you knew, would you not kick yourself in the butt if somebody came along who did keep good records, and they worked your location for you? Let's say you hired them, and they kept records, and they said, you know, Tuesdays and Saturdays really suck. We're really not seeing that much. I mean, our week looks good, the total, but Tuesday and Saturdays just not so much. So I've been taking the cart over here, and I've been tripling the money on those days. where we were making 140 a day on Tuesday and Saturday, we're making, you know, 390 now a day. Well, all of a sudden, the math got better and you didn't work anymore. You just worked smarter. Another option, and I wish Jason was here to share this with you, because it's something that he pushed on me. You know, this is where somebody, a vendor comes along and goes, Ben, you could do this a better way. And he pushed more profit. Create a niche and push more profit. If you're in an area that you think you can't get it more, you're probably wrong, is what he would tell you. I'm going to tell you that you don't want to burn bridges, but you want to try stuff. If you're worried about raising the price, then why not add a new item? Add a quarter pound dog and say it's $5, fills you up, money back guarantee. Okay? And make more profit on an item and see if that doesn't change things. I mean, Jason was telling me 2 years ago, a year and a half, 2 years ago, I needed to be at $3 on my dogs, not two. Well, he was right. People didn't care. They can't get that quality and that food that fresh, so they will pay it. And it's still not a ripoff. It's still a bargain. You talk about a $6 value meal, that is a bargain. Now, what else can we do? What else can we do to increase our to bring up those numbers? Let's say we're 150 or 250 a day or 350 a day, and we want to be at five to make this work. So we could have alternative sources that infuse more cash. And we've talked about this, and you can look it up after the show or look it up this week. And if you get overwhelmed with the amount of information, I've got over almost 500 articles now on the blog at learnhotdogs.com. There's over 100 videos, free for the taking. But I want you to know something. That may sound overwhelming. You go, I'll never get to it. Well, you'll never get to it if you don't start. But one thing you can do to make this work is you can take you can go, you know what, I'm not going to try to catch up on all Ben's crap. Okay, it's just too much. So what you do is go to the blog and you type in the search box something you're particularly interested in. I'm interested in catering. I'm interested in making money with a commissary. I'm interested in expanding my business. And you type in those keywords and it will pull up all the articles we've done, all the shows I've done on it. And then go, I'm going to listen to one of these a week. Just one. And over time, you're going to build up this huge base of knowledge. You'll be smarter than any one single individual in this business because you have amassed a bunch of knowledge. And knowledge is power in this business. It helps you work smarter and make more money. So back to number four here. Number four was alternative sources that infuse more cash, like catering and events. We need more of that. We need more of those things. Now, that means maybe on two slow days a week, you go, you know what? I'm going to start pushing some catering. And if I can get one catering job that gives me another $500, $600 a week, or even every 2 weeks, that's better than working those 2 days, because those 2 days are making me $300 total. So I traded 2 days for one. That means I got another day I can use for something. I don't care for events as much, but catering? Absolutely. So how can you make money catering? I'm not going to go into this deep, but I'm telling you, there is a butt ton of money out there for people, vendors who use catering, who put it on Craigslist, who put a little ad in the newspaper. I'll tell you a secret about the newspaper real quick. This is in my book, but if you will call the newspaper and you try to put in a classified ad, they're expensive as hell, okay? And most vendors that have tried that, they go, oh my gosh, this is expensive. Well, a little trick I learned is that display ads are the ads in the newspaper part, not the classifieds. Well, they're cheaper, not for a day. They're cheaper in the long run. And you can typically go to a newspaper and get a 30-day display ad. So what I'd buy is their smallest display ad, a 30-day ad, and it was one column inch by one column inch. Not a big ad, little tiny, it would be buried in the newspaper. But in the classifieds, it got seen. Why? Because it was a display ad in the classifieds. What made it a display ad? I didn't just put a black line around it in black ink. What I did is reverse the ink. I made the ad black and the lettering white, or the color of the newspaper. So what it did is it jumped off the page. And it can say, we cater. It can say whatever you want. We cater parties. We have food carts. You know, you can put your company name. You don't want to put a bunch of stuff that doesn't matter to them. Like, they probably don't care if your name is this and this is your tagline. You could put licensed caterer, hot dog cart, real authentic hot dog cart, or just put authentic hot dog cart. Yeah, that gets people's attention. And kind of lay out the ad the way you want it with your phone number. You'll start getting calls. You can use the link we gave you where you can get booked jobs and they start coming in. Jason just did it, and he's been overwhelmed with the amount of catering gigs people are contacting him about. I shared that a couple weeks ago again. That's from 2 years ago. That's on the blog. Type in catering, you'll pull up that article. The bottom line is you can make money, bigger money, than standing on a street corner. Now, some street corners are phenomenal. Okay, they're phenomenal, and you wouldn't want to leave them. I know vendors that are in front of a Lowe's making $1,500 in a day. In a day. They're working their tail ends off, but they're making really good money. And eventually they expand. There's a guy here in Tennessee that has, he's in Middle Tennessee, and I think he's up to four or five now Lowe's and Home Depot's locations, and has a crew working for him. Well, he didn't get there immediately. I can tell you that. He did this one at a time, and he stuck to it, and he was consistent. And you may be going, well, that's Lowe's or Home Depot. That's different. No, it isn't. There's people making more than that or that and more in front of other places. You don't have to be in Lowe's and Home Depot. I just gave that as an example. So that's where we are, okay? We've had four things that we can change to make us 500 a day as far as our average 500 a day. We can work more days, which means we don't have to make as much per day to get our average. We can change locations or get better management of our locations. We can increase profit per meal and alternative sources like catering events. That's four different things, and you can do some or all. You can do one or all. You don't have to do them all, but you have it available. You have it available. And the vendors that I've talked to that have really worked their tails off and have been successful, okay, they'll tell me that they tried these things. They tried these four things, and this is the one that stuck. These are the locations. So they may have worked their butts off for a short time, and then they started figuring it out. Okay, with good record keeping, I now can do this, and I can put this here, and I can put the card over here, and I can do it exactly this way. And that's what they do. I'm going to take another short break, and then we're going to take some calls, and then we're going to finish up with this thing. I've got more to that. Believe it or not, there's more. And we're halfway through the show. We do have some callers on the line. I'll be getting to you in just a second. Thanks for holding.
Cruising around the internet and can't find a good place to hang out? You need to stop at learnhotdogs.com and check out Ben's free training videos. He'll teach you how to steam, boil, and grill hot dogs. He'll also show you how to get your hands on some hot steamy buns. It's all over there at learnhotdogs.com. It's Sunday night at 8:30, and you're riding a gravy train with biscuit wheels with a hot dog answer man, Ben, on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio. Want to save even more money? Build your own professional hot dog cart. Save over $1,000 at buildacart.com.
Buildacart.com.
You want to roll with the big dogs? You need a cart that you can rely on. There's no better way to know your equipment than to build it yourself.
Buildacart.com.
You want to rock their world? Build this cart.
Build it and they will come.
Buildacart.com.
I thank y'all for hanging on. It allowed me to light another cigarette and take a swig of my Diet Pepsi, and I don't even have it loaded tonight. So this is all the sober me. Let's see. We have, golly, there's a bunch of people on tonight. Thank you for listening and watching. If you are listening in, which there's quite a few of you listening in through the Blog Talk Radio portal, you also can listen and watch at streetfoodvendor.tv, streetfoodvendor.tv. And you can go down that page, watch the video, and there's a chat room. And there's people in the chat room. You may have questions. You may have answers for other people. And you can help each other out. It's a great place to go. Now, after the show, you're welcome to stay there. But there is a forum, okay? And it's called Street Vendor Forum. Yeah, Street Food. No, it's streetvendorforum.com. Streetvendorforum.com. You can go there, and there's a buttload of vendors talking, asking questions, helping each other out for the more experienced vendors. Help people out. It does good. It helps everybody. So if you need help, have a question, want to talk to some experienced vendors, I mean, people like Doug's Dogs over there. There's a lot of vendors over there that have a lot of experience. I browsed it today and was looking at some of the answers people were giving, and I was going, wow. There's a lot of knowledge in here. It's like a free bank of knowledge, and it doesn't cost you anything. And I don't even think they have ads or anything up. So you don't get barraged with crap. Let's see where we are now. Caller area code, let's see, area code 706, I believe. Yeah, you've been holding the longest. Area code 706, you are live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV.
Good.
Hey, Mr. Michael Wood, how you?
How y'all doing today? I'm not give out, to be honest with you. I had one of my biggest events that I do every year, a barbecue cook-off. Well, Kansas City barbecue cook-off.
Wow.
It's a state barbecue championship, and I exceeded my sales higher than any year since I've been doing it. Out of all the years I've been doing it, I exceeded my sales.
Now, how in the world do you know that?
I went back and looked.
Because you kept records, right? I was just talking about you.
Well, I can tell you exactly to the penny how much more I made. but the funny thing about it was I had one of my T-shirts that I wear hanging on a hanger, and it was in the way, and so I just hung it outside on my canopy, on my 10x10 canopy, and I think you might have seen it in the picture.
Yeah.
And the girl came up and bought it.
Oh, wow.
She says, well, how much do you want for it? And I said, oh, hell, $12. And she came back, and she gave me $12 and bought the damn T-shirt. It just amazed me. By the way, I only paid $6 for the T-shirt, and so I doubled my money on that. But we had a real good time. We had a girl from Nashville down. God, she was just on the Grand Ole Opry. I can't think of her dang name.
She was at this Kansas City barbecue cook-off?
Yeah.
Were you serving barbecue?
No.
You were doing hot dogs.
I was doing hot dogs and sausage dogs, the same thing I do all the time with my big dog hot dog truck.
All right.
And, all them guys cooking barbecue, when they come in, they don't want to eat barbecue. And then you got kids that are coming in, and parents aren't going to pay, you know, $15 for a barbecue plate for a 7-year-old.
Right.
So they come over and get my hot dogs. And I normally sell as many sausage dogs as I do hot dogs at the event, which tickles me. I ran out of water. I had two customers come up after I ran out of water. And wanting water, and I was just totally out. And I was running four coolers.
So wow.
And I had to fill them up. So that'll give you some idea how many drinks that I did in the 2 days. And then to make it all great, my wife got sick and they had to take her to the hospital. And so that left me all by myself the rest of the night, Friday night, and all day Sunday, and while she sat in the hospital. But,
wow.
You know, me being a hardhead, I just stayed running my hot dog cart.
Is she all right?
There wasn't nothing I could... Yeah, she'll live, I hope. yeah, she'll be all right. She was dehydrated, and they're still running tests on her. She's supposed to get out tomorrow, I hope.
You were working her too hard, Michael.
No, I was actually coddling her too much. I should have worked her harder. But,
you're going to have all our lady friend listeners pissed off and burn us out.
Well, you want to see how much she gets paid. I'll tell you what. I'll give you some idea how much she gets paid. She gets as much as my check that I got this month from Ben's Carts.
Oh, my gosh.
That's how much. Boy, that was a bigger one.
Oh my gosh, that's all the zeros in the wrong spot.
I know. I've been on the blog and trying to answer a few questions. A lot of people are asking about, you know, how much propane do you take, or you know, different questions. And like you just said, you can go on Street Vendor Forum and ask the questions. If I can't answer it, somebody can. And if you can't find it, Google it. That's
the
easiest way to find anything.
And all you vendors that have been doing this a while, you may want to stop by there and help out. There's a lot of new vendors. This is the time of year because of this late, you know, the winter lasted so long. I'm getting... just ridiculous amounts of emails. I've even implemented a program that starts searching the emails, and it finds ones that have a particular question that we've allotted for. Like it may say, well, here's a common one, do you ship? Even though that's at the top of every page on the website. But it will auto send them a response. People that go, which kind of dog do I serve? It will find the keywords, and if it matches, but it also tells them, if this didn't answer your question, here's Ben's direct email, send him an email, and or reply back to this one. And so I still get them, but what it's done is cut it down, but I had to implement something just to take away some of the questions. So it would be nice if there was some other vendors that wanted to go to the street vendor, because I'm not getting those questions. I don't have time. And so... If you have some time and you can donate 30 minutes a week or something to it, go over there and answer some questions. Even if they've been answered, you may answer it better or in a different way that's more understandable.
Bingo, because a lot of people know stuff a lot or can explain it a lot better, too.
Right, right.
One other thing that a little trick that I've come up with is I keep a 1-pound propane tank on my cart. I'm running regular... propane tanks, like, you know, are designed for a big dog.
Right.
But a 1-pound backup tank for emergencies that if I run out of propane completely and I can't send somebody to the store or whatever, I just hook it in and I have enough propane to get through whatever event or, you know, or if I'm on the street or wherever.
That's smart. That's super smart. To always have, that's Boy Scout stuff right there. Be prepared.
Yeah.
Hey, tell me this, and I know you work part time with the hot dogs, but did you hear the first part of the show about making $20,000 in 3 months?
Yeah, and okay, all right. I'm gonna tell everybody a big secret. I made about $1,200 this weekend. Is what I've had in sales. Okay, tell me where you can make $600 a day doing anything. Even if you take my food costs, my time, my trouble, gas, and everything out.
If I wanted to ask you, While we're on that, I don't need an exact number, but how close was I to your figure with my 32% overall cost?
About right. That's what I've got to figure. Three times my feed cost is what I figure everything.
Good.
And that's a standard restaurant operating procedure. One third for the food, one third for profit, and one third for operating costs. And that's the way. So if you make $600 in a day in sales, you're going to bring home $200 profit.
Well, see, I did my numbers the other way. I took out my, now I didn't take my time, okay, because that's all variable to who you are. I mean, some people are worth more to themselves than I am.
Looking as I am, I have to get paid.
Well, I understand that, but I wanted you to do it without your pay because my number's 33% right now. 33% is my total cost, not counting my own pay. So net profit to the company is 66% roughly out of every dollar.
Yeah. You can. Because another thing is, too, once you buy a hot dog cart, build a hot dog cart, buy a used one, new one, or whatever, you have a set cost, then you're going to make that cost back.
Right.
Then after that, everything's a profit.
Right.
You know.
And, you're exactly right.
You know. I mean, that's the way I figure it. And then on top of that, while I was there at that event, everybody's talking about they can't get business. I booked another event for another car lot. The guy came up and asked me, gave me his card and said, I'm having my grand opening or reopening, and I want you to come to this town and set your hot dog cart up. And I'm going, okay, it'll be about $6 a meal.
Right.
And I'll see you. And so, you know, I mean, you can get business, but you got to do your due diligence, as
right.
Everybody says.
Yep.
If you go out and buy a hot dog cart and you haven't talked to the health department and you haven't had any experience about anything, you don't know how to add one and one, you haven't checked out for locations. If you haven't done all these things, what you're doing is buying a good fishing weight. And I mean, I really believe that. You've got to do your homework. If you don't do your homework, don't complain.
Or don't complain loud enough where we can hear you.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it just, you know, and things are going to go wrong. You're going to have a spot that, when I started out in business, I coordinated with a organization to set up my hot dog cart, and they were just so happy to have me. And then I took the hot dog cart down there, and they said, well, we've changed management, and we can't have you now. And I went, let's go to Plan B.
Right.
I went to Plan B, walked in, and set my cart up, and I've been going ever since.
Wow.
But I've always had a Plan B for everything I've done. Gotta have it.
I'm with you.
But we had a good weekend, you know, other than my wife having her little thing. But I had a good time. That girl's name is Natalie Stovall.
Oh, yeah. I've heard of her. Yep.
Yeah, she was the entertainment. And
that's awesome.
Brought in a good crowd.
Good.
I had my hot dog eating contest too, and we gave away $200 in prize money. The first, second, and third place got a Doug's Dog T-shirt. Woo! And and I got all kinds of advertisements.
Wow.
And by the way, the $200 prize money was donated by a local Ford dealership that I also vend at. So it didn't cost me anything except for the hot dogs and the T-shirts.
Wow.
So and
that was smart.
I got a half-page ad in the program for the event. My name is actually on the T-shirt for the event, or Doug's Dogs is. So, I mean, you know, I spend a little money, make a little money. I mean, that's what life is. Let me get off here so you can answer the other calls, because I know you don't want to stay late.
No, we
Happy
got...
Happy Mother's Day to all the mamas.
That's right. Happy Mother's Day. Thanks, and tell your wife we're thinking about her and hope she gets to feeling better soon.
All right. Talk to y'all later, guys.
See you later. All right. That was Mr. Michael Wood out of Georgia with Doug's Dogs. Caller, I'm going to have time possibly for one more caller. The next one in line is 850. If I have time, it'll be short, and I apologize. I need to finish this up real quick. I do want to tell the person that I told that I would read his email online. It is he's asking about leasing his cart out, like doing drop-off services and leasing it out to events and fundraisers. I think it's a fantastic idea. The short answer, learnhotdogs.com and type in drop-off. Type in expanding your business. Type in leasing your cart. Type in those words. You'll pull up the article. If you have any trouble, please email me again, and I'll find it for you. We've done several on it, but the drop-off service is kick butt, and I think it's a great way for you to make some extra money. He's in the Army, and so he's not using it as much as he thought, and so he thought about using the money, using the cart elsewhere, letting somebody else make money with it. And that's wise. I've got vendors that have bought extra carts just to do that. Let me finish up where I was going with all this tonight. Here's the four things you need to do in order for all this to work. We've already talked about good record keeping, so I'm not going to beat that horse anymore. Good work ethics, though. You must be able to make yourself get up. It's harder. For many people, it's hard, and even people that are self-motivated and go, 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 it's still hard sometimes. You get tired, and you don't want to get up tomorrow morning. Or you go, you know what, it looks like rain. Yeah. And you look at your phone, and it says 30% chance of rain, and you go, yeah, I'm not going to go to work. And those are benefits to being self-employed. But if you want to make this work, you want to make the 20 grand, go out there and do it. Go out there and do it. Requires reevaluation of your setup, okay? Immediately, if you're not already making 500 a day and you plan on doing the 51 days of work in 3 months, then reevaluate your setup. So it may not require more work days and changing locations and increasing profit per meal and alternative sources. It could be as simple as your setup looking like crap. Or it could still look good, but it could look better. There could be something simple you could change that increases your volume by 20 or 30 people a day. Wouldn't you like to know what those things are? Well, it turns out I've done, I think, 5 now, cart critiques, cart setup critiques, where people have said, yes, go ahead and tear this apart. Tell me what I'm doing wrong. And I took their photos or video, and I made a cart critique. So if you type in cart critique on the blog, you'll pull those up. You can go to our YouTube channel and check those out there as well. So you'll be able to see exactly what I'm looking for to increase someone's business. And if you talk to these vendors later and that did these things, that implemented these little changes, and their profit went up. One guy in front of a Dollar General changed one thing. He made a bigger sign with a price. And he was still at the time using value meal. So it said, two dogs, drink, chips, and it had a big number 5 on it. He did that one thing, and immediately his sales doubled. Before, when he was just getting people pulling already into Dollar General, he now was getting people pulling off into the parking lot just to get his hot dogs. Why did that make that big of a difference? Well, I talk about that in those videos. They're free for the taking. Take advantage of this stuff. Also, never quit. There will be bad days, period, that are beyond your control. They're just alignment of the moon and something about, you know, fairies with broken wings or something. Don't worry. Don't think it's you. Always keep good records. You may find a pattern. You may find something. I've had vendors for years call me and go, you know what I've noticed? I'm really busy at the beginning of the month, and then it kind of just peters out. Well, why is that? Many people in America, the biggest bulk of America, is retired now. It's the baby boomer generation. They're on fixed incomes. When do they get their checks? Beginning of the month. When do they eat out the most? Beginning of the month. When do they do grocery shopping? Beginning of the month. That's why. So you capitalize on those. Maybe you work 7 days in a row at the beginning of the month, or 10 days in a row, and then towards the middle you work, throw in another seven. And then you're done for the month. That may be your 17 days or 20 days, whatever it is. You may figure out, oh my gosh, I wish I could have two of those the fifth day of the month, because they are really good. Check cashing places. Banks. Some banks will let you set up in front of them. There's all kinds of ways to make money and get in front of the right people. Now, all this comes down to is you must invest. You must invest your time to learn, and your money. And to some of you, this is going to be overwhelming. You're going to go, oh, I'd rather go work at McDonald's and just, I know I'm going to make this much and I'll be happy there. That isn't who I'm talking to. For the most part, vendors are something extremely different. They're 180 degrees out from somebody working at McDonald's. Okay? Not that there's anything wrong with that, and I'm happy there's people that are working at McDonald's because I like McDonald's. But some of us want more. We want more. We're not satisfied with this much. And so we are the ones that go out and do more. We're the ones that go always looking for an opportunity to make life richer. Not financially necessarily, but richer. So that you have more time with your family. More time to do things you want to do. Maybe you like to read a lot and you want a day off, just nothing to read. Nothing but read. Or you want to fish. Or you like picking up shells. Or you got a metal detector. All of that can be yours. And if you talk to the vendors that have been doing this, they get that. We get that. We get those times. We get those freedoms because of that. Hot dogs save my life, literally, and can save yours too. Okay? I hope you enjoyed this tonight. I wanted to motivate you and encourage you, because none of this is out of the question. None of this is impossible. And you may be struggling, or you may be trying. Call in next week and talk to me and say, tell me what you're doing, and I'll try to see if where you're missing something. But try these things, and I hope you wrote them down. I will copy this, my script, and it may have misspellings and stuff in it, but I'll put it on the blog tomorrow. And you'll be able to see, and you'll be able to go back to it and go, okay, I need to do this one thing he mentioned. Try it, and you can change your life. It won't be a matter of going, you know what, I got another job offer and I don't have to do this hot dog thing anymore. This hot dog thing is a way out for many. It's $100,000 a year income for many. It's a $60,000 year income for many. And that's good. If you're making $30,000 a year, you're over 80% of the population in income. I know that's sad, but that's pretty well off. So I wish you well, and I hope that I helped you some, and I hope you change. Area code 850, you're live. We got about a minute left.
Hey, Ben, how you doing? This is Gordon Flying Poppy down here in the Panhandle.
Hey, Mr. Flying Poppy, I love your truck. Sexy. How you been doing?
I appreciate that. Hey, we're doing very well. The last week was our first week in production or out there for
90 seconds.
And, we learned a million lessons. All your stuff that we spent a couple of months before we went on the road and really looked at all your videos. We tuned in, and I can't tell you from the bottom of my heart, man, that a lot of that stuff just clicked in. So much so that we were able to score a Walmart Thursday, Friday, and Saturday from in June. We're going to start in June. We're going to be there indefinitely.
60 seconds.
We're going to be there at 11, and we're going to close up at 6 because we figured we went there a week ago, And we found that that was where the money was at. You know, all that walk-in traffic, man, you can't beat that. So we're going to do that. We got our buns locally by a baker. It's a it's potato roll.
Right.
And what's taken off down here, believe it or not, in this town, is the Chicago dog. You know, they haven't experienced it down here. It's something new, and they're loving it. And I'm selling it for $4. So,
will you do me a favor and call in next week? And no matter where you fall in there, I'm going to pick you up, but, I hate to cut you off, but we got to go, and I thank you for calling in.
No problem. We'll talk.
10 seconds. Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio.